Hello everyone, welcome back to Chen Daddy Advice. If you are new here, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on notification bell so you will notify when I upload a new video. And don't forget to follow me on my social medias. You can share and tag me when you made my crochet pattern. I'm happy to see your crochet work. Okay, now in today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a spiderweb hoodie. It is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. For this sweater, I make for size small and size medium, but I also showing you how to make it bigger for any size. Okay, now let's get into the video. First thing first, we are going to make the back part of the sweater. To begin, make a slip knot. Then chain 4. After you got 4 chains, then we are going to connect this chain together to create the circle by make slip stitch into the first chain. To make slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull through all the loops. And as you can see, we have the small hole in the middle of the foundation chains, and we are going to work in the stitch into this middle loop. Next, for round 1, chain 4. For chain 4, we count as a stitch, it's a treble crochet stitch. Then add one more chain, in total you must have 5 chains. And next, we are going to make treble crochet into the middle loop. To make treble or triple crochet, yarn over twice. Insert the hook into the middle loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 4 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And now you have 3 loops on the hook. Then yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. And now you must have 2 last loops on the hook. Then yarn over and pull through these 2 last loops. And this is how we made treble or triple crochet. After you have made a treble crochet, then chain 1 and make another treble crochet into the middle loop. Repeating this by chain 1 and make a treble crochet into the same loop, which is the middle loop, until you got 15 stitches of treble crochet. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you got 15 treble crochet. In total stitch, you must have 16 stitches, include the chain stitch. And after you got 16 stitches, and then chain 1, and we are going to make slip stitch into the chain stitch to connect the row. Count 3 chains and make slip stitch into the 4th chain. And this is what the first round looks like. Next, for round 2, chain 4. Like I said, chain 4 count as a stitch. It's a treble crochet stitch, and then add one more chain. It is for a chain space. Then make a treble crochet into the chain space. After you have made a treble crochet into the chain space, then chain 1 and make a treble crochet into a treble crochet stitch of the round below. Keep repeating this by chain 1 and make treble crochet into the chain space, then chain 1 and make treble crochet into treble crochet stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. For this round 2, you must have 32 stitches in total, include the chain stitch. And then chain 1. And we are going to make slip stitch into the chain stitch by count 3 chains and make slip stitch into the 4th chain. And next, for round 3, chain 4 as a treble crochet stitch, and then we are going to increase the number of the chain space by add one more chain to your previous row. In total, you must have 6 chains. And next, we are going to skip the chain space and make treble crochet into treble crochet stitch. After you have made treble crochet into treble crochet stitch, then chain 2. And then skip chain space and make treble crochet into treble crochet stitch. Keep repeating this by chain 2, skip chain space and make treble crochet into treble crochet stitch until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And after you reach the last double crochet stitch, then chain 2, skip chain space, and we are going to make slip stitch into the chain stitch by make slip stitch into the 4th chain. Remember, you always make slip stitch into the 4th chain. And this is what it looks like. And next, for round 4, chain 4 as a treble crochet stitch, and then we are going to increase the number of the chain space by add one more chain to your previous row. In the previous row, we make 6 chains, and the next row you have to make 7 chains, and then skip chain space and make treble crochet into treble crochet stitch. And this is what it looks like. Keep repeating this by chain 3 and make treble crochet into treble crochet stitch until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the 4th chain. And for the next row, you just keep repeating this by increase the number of the chains. At the beginning, you will add one more chain to the previous number of the chains and then make treble crochet into treble crochet stitch and then increase one more chain in between each of treble crochet stitches. Repeat around until the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the fourth chain. You have to keep increasing until you reach row 7, then we meet you back again. As you can see, at the center or the middle of the round, we have a big space or a big gap between each round. And after you reach row 7, then I'm gonna show you how to make the small space between each round. So for the small space between each round, I use double crochet stitch and everything is repeat the same thing like we use treble crochet stitch. Remember, for this blue yarn, it is just a sample showing you how to crochet the stitches, so you don't get confused. You just repeat the writing pattern or the instruction that I showed in this video. So for round 8 until round 17, increase the number of the chains. Chain 3, it is count as a double crochet stitch. Then look at your previous row. I made 2 chains, so I have to make 3 more chains for the chain space. In total, I have 6 chains, include the chain 3, count as a double crochet stitch. And next, we are going to make double crochet into treble crochet stitch. To make double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and then yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. And next, increase the number of the chain space, then make double crochet into treble crochet stitch. Keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the third chain. Because chain 3 we count as double crochet stitch, so you have to make slip stitch into the third chain. And for the next row, you just repeat the same thing by increase the number of the chain and then make double crochet and then increase the number of the chain. It is like we made the treble crochet round. Repeat until you reach row 17, then we meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 17. And this is also the size that I want for my sweater. If you guys that make bigger size, please add more rows by keep increasing until you got your desired fit. And then for one more row, it's the last row, I'm gonna show you how to make this web drop. It's like the loose web. First, you have to use stitch marker to mark at any stitch that you want. Then count 7 chain spaces or count 7 double crochet stitches away from the stitch marker. Then use stitch marker to mark at the 8th double crochet stitch. As you can see, for the 7 chain spaces, it is the measurement or the length of your shoulder part, or we call it as a width of the sweater. And next, count 9 chain spaces or 8 double crochet stitches away from the stitch marker. Then use stitch marker to mark at the 9th double crochet stitch. And then count 7 chain spaces again or 6 double crochet stitches away from the stitch marker. Then use stitch marker to mark at the 7th double crochet stitch. And as you can see, for the remaining stitches or the chain space, we have 9 chain spaces the same like the other side. For the 9 chain spaces, it is the length of your sweater. And next, for round 18 or the last round of your back part, increase chain as usual. Then make double crochet into double crochet stitch. And after you have made double crochet, then make many chains as you want. It is for the web drop or the loose web. And after you got your desired length, then fold it like this. And then we are going to make slip stitch into the double crochet stitch. After you have made slip stitch and this is what it looks like, then make the chain space width increase as usual. And make the bulk crochet into the bulk crochet stitch. Then make the long foundation chains again. You have to make one is long and one is short. And after you got your desired length, then make slip stitch into the bulk crochet stitch. And this is what it looks like. And one more thing, you also can make the web drop at the middle of the chain space too by make many chains as you want. Next, we are going to make slip stitch into the chain. Example that your chain space have 9 chains, so you have to count 4 chains and make slip stitch into the 5th chain. And after you have made slip stitch into the chain, then continue add more chains until you got the length of your chain space. Then continue make the bulk crochet into the bulk crochet stitch. And as you can see, the web drop is at the middle of the chain space. So you just keep repeating this until you reach the other stitch marker, then we meet you back again. And after you reach the stitch marker, and this is what it looks like. For this web drop, it is the bottom part of your sweater. And for the rest of the stitches, you just make no more the bulk crochet stitch, then increase chain space. Repeat around until you reach the end of the row and make slip stitch into the 3rd chain. And after you have made slip stitch, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And now the back part of my sweater is done. And this is what it looks like. And for the width length of my sweater, it is equal 18.5 inches length. And for the length of my sweater, it is equal 21 inches. Like I said, if you guys want your sweater more bigger, you have to add more rows by increase around until you got your desired fit. And next, for the front part, we repeat the same thing like the back part from round 1 until round 14. For this back part, we have 18 rounds in total. And for the front part, we also make 18 rounds the same, but you have to keep 4 rounds left for making the neckline. Next, continue from where your last stitch is. For round 15, we are going to make decrease by decrease 3 chains from your previous chain at the beginning of the row. For the chain 3 that we decrease, it is count as a double crochet stitch. It's like we are decrease the double crochet stitch. And for the chain space, we still increase the same. So for my previous chain space, I make 13 chains. And for my new round, I make 14 chains. Like I said, you only decrease 3 chains that count as a double crochet stitch. And then we are going to continue make double crochet into the double crochet stitch. After you have made a double crochet, and this is what it looks like. It should look like italics line. And next, you just make no more increased chain. Then make the double crochet into the double crochet stitch. Repeat around until you have 2 last chain spaces from the chain space that we made decrease. Then we meet you back again. After you have 2 last chain spaces, then we are going to make decrease again like we start at the beginning of the row by making increase chain as usual. And then we are not going to make the bulk crochet into the bulk crochet stitch, but instead by make slip stitch into the bulk crochet stitch. After you have made slip stitch, and this is what it looks like. And next, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And for the last chain space, we are going to skip it. Next, for round 16, skip the decreasing chain space and attach the yarn into the bogus shape stitch. Then make increase chain as usual. And then make the bogus shape into the bogus shape stitch. And keep repeating this around until you reach the last double crochet stitch, which is near the decreased chain space. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the last double crochet stitch, then make the double crochet into that last double crochet stitch. And for the decreased chain space, we are going to skip it. And as you can see, for this chain 3 spaces at the middle, which is between both rows, it is count as the neckline. And next, for round 17, make increase chain as usual by chain 3 as a double crochet stitch, turn your work, and continue make the chain space with increase. Then make double crochet into the double crochet stitch. Keep repeating around until you reach the end of the row. Then we meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make the double crochet into the third chain. After you have made the double crochet into the third chain, and this is what it looks like. And next, count 2 chain spaces or 2 double crochet stitches and use stitch marker to mark at the third double crochet. And then count the same number to the other side, and you must have 7 chain spaces between both stitch marker. It is the width length of your sweater or your shoulder pad, and then count 9 chain spaces and mark it. It is the length or the height of your sweater, and you have to count the same number like we did with the back part of the sweater, as you can see with this sample. Because for the last round, which is round 18, we are going to make the web drop like we did with the back part. Next, for round 18, make increase chain as usual. Then make the double crochet into the double crochet stitch. Keep repeating this around until you reach the stitch marker, which is the bottom part of the sweater. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the bottom part of the sweater, then we are going to make the web drop, but repeat the same thing like we did with the back part of the sweater. Keep making the web drop until you reach the other stitch marker or until you got 7 chain spaces. Then I will meet you back again. Thank you. this is what the web drop looks like after you reach the 17th space. And next, you just continue make the bulk shade, then make increase chain as usual. Repeat until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, then chain one and cut off the yarn, and this is what it looks like. Remember, for both parts must be have the same number of the rounds. Next, we are going to attach these both parts together by attach the shoulder part first. For the length of the shoulder part, you have to count 2 chain spaces from the neckline part. For attaching the shoulder part together, I'm using smaller hook, which is 2.5 mm hook. To begin, insert the hook into the corner stitch, which is the bulkhead stitch, and then continue insert the hook into the other double crochet stitch. And next, chain 1. Then we are going to make slip stitch both sides together by insert the hook into both sides loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Next, for the chain stitch, we are going to make slip stitch chain with chain by insert the hook into both upper loop of the chain. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Keep repeating this into every chain and into the double crochet stitch until you reach the stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the stitch marker. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the back side or the front side looks like. Both sides look similar. And next, please repeat the same thing to the other side. And this is what the neckline or the neck hole looks like. And next, we are going to make the sleeves. But first, you have to start attach from this bottom part, measuring from the top of the shoulder part, which is where we make slip stitch both sides together until you reach 6 inches length. It is the size or the width of my sleeves. And for my arm or my sleeve circumference, it is equal to 12 inches length. For you guys that make bigger size, you can measuring it with your desired fit. And next, we are going to attach this both sides of the sweater together until you reach the stitch marker. To begin, attach the yarn into the next chain space away from where you make the web drop by insert the hook into both double crochet stitch. Chain 1 and we are going to make slip stitch both sides together like we did at the shoulder part. Keep making slip stitch both sides together until you reach the stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you have made slip stitch until you reach the stitch marker. And next, we are going to make the sleeve. For making the sleeve, I'm switching back to my regular hook, which is 3.5 mm hook. Then for round 1, chain 3 is count as a double crochet stitch. And then we are going to make the chain space the same number like the row below. So at the row below, I have 10 chains. So for your next row, you have to make the same number of the chains like the row below by make 10 chains the same. In total, you must have 13 chains, include the chain 3 stitch. Then make double crochet into double crochet stitch. And for my next chain space at the row below, I have 17 chains. And for my next row, I have to make 17 chains the same. And after you got 17 chains, then make double crochet into double crochet stitch. So for the sleeve part, we are not going to make increase at the chain space. Just make a straight normal chain space. Keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row. Then we meet you back again. So my chain space at the row below, I have 10 chains. And for my next row, I have to make 10 chains the same. After you got 10 chains, then we are going to make slip stitch into the third chain. After you have made slip stitch, and this is what it looks like. And next, for round 2, chain 3 as a double crochet stitch. And continue make 10 chains the same like the chain space at the row below. Then make double crochet into double crochet stitch and make the same number of the chain space of the row below. Then make double crochet into double crochet stitch. Keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row. Then make slip stitch into the third chain. For the next row, you just keep repeating round 2 until you reach round 6. And for round 7 until round 23, you have to chain 4 as a treble crochet stitch. So we just repeat the same thing, but the difference is I switch from double crochet to treble crochet stitch. And for round 24 until round 30, I use with double crochet stitch. And after you got your desired length of the sleeves, for the last row, don't forget to make the web wrap around like we did at the body part. And for the measurement of my sleeve, measuring from row 1 until row 30, it is equal 25 inches length. If you guys want your sleeve more longer, please add more rows. And for the bottom part of my sweater, I skip 1 chain space away from where we made the wet drop. And I also skip 1 space at the other side. In total, I have 9 chain spaces because when I try it on my body, it's a little bit tight at the bottom part. That's why I skip 1 more chain space for each side. And next, please repeat the same thing to the other side. And now the sweater almost done. Next, we are going to make the hood for the sweater. For the hood of the sweater, we make out from the half shape of the spider web. It's like the half shape of the circle. So we repeat the same thing like the full circle, it's just a little bit different. To begin, make a slip knot and chain 4. After you got 4 chains, then make slip stitch into the first chain to create the circle. Next, for row 1, chain 5. And after you got 5 chains, then make treble crochet into the circle. After you have made a treble crochet, then chain 1. Keep repeating this into the circle until you got 9 treble crochet stitches. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the 9 treble crochet stitch, in total you must have 10 stitches include the chain stitch. Next, for row 2, chain 5. Turn your work, then make treble crochet into the chain space. Then chain 1 and make treble crochet into treble crochet stitch. Please keep repeating this by chain 1, make treble crochet into the chain space. Keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And next, chain 1 and make treble crochet into this chain stitch by count 3 chains and make treble crochet into the 4th chain. And this is what the second row looks like. You must have 18 stitches include the chain stitch. Next, for row 3, chain 4 as a treble crochet stitch, then make increase chain like we did with the full spider web. By chain 2, turn your work, skip chain space and make treble crochet into treble crochet stitch. Then increase chain again by chain 2 and make treble crochet into treble crochet stitch. Keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the stitch that near chain stitch, then chain 2 and make treble crochet into the 4th chain. And this is what the third row looks like. For the next row, please keep increasing by increasing the chain at the beginning of the row, then make treble crochet into treble crochet stitch, and increase the number of the chain space between treble crochet stitches. Keep increasing until you reach row 11, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach row 11, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the hood or the half shape of the spider web looks like. If you guys want your hood more bigger or longer, you just add more rows by keep increasing. For the length of my hood, it is equal 9 inches length. And next, please repeat the same thing to the other side. After you got 2 pieces of the hood, next we are going to attach this hood into the neckline. You have to keep 1 chain space at the middle of your sweater or your neckline, as you can see in this picture. And then we are going to start attaching the hood with the neckline, start from where we use stitch marker to mark, which is where we make the crease, until you reach the back side of the neckline or the sweater. So for the back neckline, we also have 3 chain spaces the same like the front neckline. Count 1 chain space, and for the middle chain space, you have to separate in half. So for my chain space, I have 17 chains. So count 8 chains and mark at the 9th chain. And now you have 1.5 chain space. As you can see in this picture, it should place at the middle part of your sweater. Place the straight side with the front part of the sweater, and then attach both edges together until you reach the middle stitch marker, which is at the back side of the sweater. By using slip stitch method that we use to attach the shoulder part together. So I already did one side. As you can see, this is what it looks like. And for the other side, we also repeat the same thing like the first side. By place the straight part of the hood with the front part of the sweater. attach the corner of the hood with the stitch where we mark. Then make slip stitch both sides together until you reach the back part of the sweater, which is where we use stitch marker to mark. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what the slip stitch seam looks like. After you reach the stitch marker, then chain one and leave the yarn there. You don't have to cut it off. And this is what both pieces of the hood looks like when you attach it into the neckline. Next, we are going to attach this curved edge of the hood together. As you can see in this picture, both edge of the hood should place at the middle part of the sweater like this. And next, continue from where your last stitch is. Then we are going to make slip stitch both sides together until you reach the end of the row. Then we meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you have made slip stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then chain one and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, you can use darning needle to weave in into the slip stitch seam. And now the hood of the sweater is done. And this is what it looks like. For all your remaining yarn, you can weave in into the double crochet stitch. Finally, your spiderweb sweater is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.